No.
What do you...
Well, I mean just that. Initially, I thought this was a prank.
Listen.
Well, with all...
I'll try to find...
Thanks. I feel like I'm being...
Thank you. This finished. Go away. Let me concentrate.
Ugh. It happened. Thanks to Rocket League for the 53,000 viewer host. That's right, that's a pog from me. And the content begins now, boys. K-Dot versus Fairy Peak coming up. But let's just get right into this one. It's time for K-Dot versus Fairy Peak. EU servers best of seven. Let's do it. I've got Fairy Peak winning this one. I know K-Dot has definitely been the more successful 3v3 player for the latter year. Or, you know, pretty much for their entire existence as 3v3 players, K-Dot has been just a little bit ahead of Fairy. Or right now, I think you could say a lot ahead of Fairy. But when it comes to 1v1, Fairy Peak has almost always had K-Dot in the bag. Again, I want to thank everybody for all these subs. This is absolutely ridiculous. I'll shout you all out later, but right now we can't be doing that. I've muted the alerts because it's going to be so loud all the way through. It's just going to be constant, so we can't have that. It's time for game one, Dignitas K-Dot versus Rhino Vitality Fairy Peak. They had a cracking series just now on Rocket League Esports. Once again, big thanks to them for the host. That is far, far too kind of you. But this is the man I expect to be winning this this year 1v1. K-Dot, extremely greedy here. Where's he going? Your goal's not that way, K-Dot. That's going to be 1-0. Fairy Peak was playing very well against Dignitas earlier, I must say. But look out for the flicks. Fairy Peak is probably, I would say, the most impressive player on the ground in the Batmobile worldwide. And that is a fantastic shot. He delayed revealing which way he was going to shoot this until pretty late on into the approach. But hey, two kickoff wins, two goals for Fairy Peak. He's not even let K-Dot out of his half yet. K-Dot slowing down the kickoff here. That's a hard counter by Fairy. I think he just hard read that. That slow approach by K-Dot. And he went for a fast kickoff himself. That is something that I have seen from K-Dot in the past. He does like to sneak in those delayed kickoffs in 1v1. Sneak him in there, maybe get a dunk, maybe a goal straight down the middle. But he's going to have to do more than that. And that's not bad, actually. Almost pinching it in off the deck to get a goal back. And the shooting for these guys is going to be the outstanding thing in this show match. If I'm going to make a prediction right now, it's going to be all about ground shots. I saw an interview with Fairy Peak once, and he was talking about how important dribbling is in 1v1. And actually, I think the interviewer asked Fairy Peak how important is dribbling in 1v1. And he said that it is important. You need to be knowing how to dribble, but you don't absolutely need to rely on it for all of your goals. And he pointed to K-Dot as a good example of that. K-Dot is so good at ground shots, and he's got such power on his shots, such accuracy, that he almost never has to go for flick plays. And what does that allow him to do? It allows him to focus almost exclusively on ball cam in offense. So his power is pretty much always going to be there. Do you guys want me to turn up the game volume? And I know that, it's a bit louder in RLCS where most of these come from. I can put it up if you want. At least a little bit. Let's see, I'm going to take a little visual poll of chat here. Alright, we'll wait until the next goal and I'll try and remember to put it up, okay? Fairy Peak should be scoring this one. It's straight at K-Dot, and K-Dot's failed to save it. Alright, I said I was going to change the volume. Let's go for it. Heh! Did it. Just for you guys. Make the sub graphics smaller. No, because I want to encourage people to fill the screen with the sub graphic. Yeah, I always have it this size. We're just going to leave that the way it is. So I think if I resize it, it actually throws off the it throws off the text to graphic ratio, and the names start appearing in the wrong line. It's difficult to get that one fixed. You want me to turn the game sound up a bit more? Yeah, we could do that. I know that in RLCS they use an awful lot of game sound, which I don't hate at all. I think the game sound sounds pretty good most of the time. Man, Fairy Peak is just dangling K-Dot all over the place here. K-Dot hanging on for dear life. And those of you who have been following K-Dot's 1v1 career, he's been a top tier 1v1 player for well over a year now, so has Fairy, of course. Fairy, considered by most to be the best 1v1 player on the planet, even though he lost his last show match on my stream versus a certain OSM, who then went on to lose his four-match winning streak to Rottweiler, so the lineal champ is currently Rottweiler of England. This is a very one-sided matchup historically in favor of Fairy Peak. K-Dot actually semi-called out Fairy Peak here. I think they had a little bit of a debate if he was the best player. And K-Dot was saying, well, look, come on, I'm on Dignitas. We've won the World Championship twice. And Fairy says, yeah, but I'll slap you around in 1v1. And then K-Dot says, no, you wouldn't. I'll take you out in 1v1 as well. So they asked for this show match. And now here it is, with quite a few people watching. Tell Twitch to let you watch ads for me. I don't know what you mean there, mate. This little pop in field there, Kato passing it to himself. He's going to need to do a lot of that this game, because he doesn't have Violent Panda and Turbo Pulse passing the ball to him right now. £711 of the prize pool. Oh my days. I just realized Sparkle Pony also donated 100. It's going to be one of the highest prize pools that we've ever had on stream. It already is. Very much appreciated, guys. Once again, I'll do sub shoutouts, donation shoutouts. I'll read all of the sub messages, all of the bit messages. I'll do all that after the series is over, because there's a few too many right now to be doing it. Very big trying to force the own goal at the moment. He was trying to get K-Dop to run into that one himself. Tell them the prize pool and viewers. K-Dop and Fairy Peak knew that there was going to be a host. Look at that by K-Dop. He's managed to get the delayed kickoff to work. Fairy Peak didn't see it this time. Check this out from Fairy's or K-Dop's POV. Running into it. He stopped in a very specific position that was difficult to know how far away he would be from the ball from Fairy Peak's perspective. K-Dop might be bringing this one back. Wisely doesn't run the ball straight into Fairy Peak there. That was actually a really good play. He took a bit too long getting moving towards the boost, and that's going to give a huge advantage to Fairy. This is a really, really solid dribble. He could volley this, half volley it, fake it, dribble it. He could do anything he wants here, and it's pretty much always going to be a good result in his favor. Tell you what though, K-Dop's gotten away from that and probably should have scored at the other end. That's essentially an open net miss. Not an easy one, but it was scoreable for a player like K-Dop. Multiple bumps right now for K-Dop, but he's just used all of his boost to do it, and he didn't really do enough damage. Fairy Peak's going to walk away with another goal. That's maybe game one in the bag, unless K-Dop can pull any more trickery on the kickoff. We'll see what K-Dop can do here. He's going to play this one pretty heads up. Of course, both these guys have had quite a lot of success playing ones on my stream in the past. Fairy Peak's been playing a lot more ones in 2018 on my stream, though, and a lot more ranked ones as well. So not just for the history between these two would I give Fairy Peak the edge, but I'd also give him the edge on current form.